Mark and Paulette here, the two travelers in Mexico with take two because someone forgot to turn on the receiver for take one. Today, we are going to talk to you about
parasites and how real they are in Mexico.
It is a real issue for sure.
For me, for sure.
Yeah, because Paulette is actually, lately she's been getting it about every 2 or 3 months. Hadn't been so much for me.
Well, I'd say 3 or 4 months it affects me. But, so parasites is something that definitely exists here in Mexico. Mm-hmm. It exists in a lot of third world countries.
Now, Mexico is not a third world country, it's a first world country, but it still has the parasite issue, certainly more than, say, the United States. Well, most of the United States, anyway. But it's a very real thing that people need to think about and be prepared for and know what to do in case you come down with an issue of parasites.
Right, and this is something lock sale is something that a lot of people do in Mexico. It comes one tablet in a box, big box, right, for one tablet. Go figure. And you only take one of these pills, and it's supposed to work on the parasites. For those that don't know anything about parasites, will hatch and lay babies in you also. So this medicine.
Okay. Well, there go about 95% of the viewers that started watching the watching the video with
what are
that
you
one.
I haven't even gotten gross yet.
Yeah, okay. I'm just warning you now.
No, I won't get that disgusting, but you could going into a lot of detail. And I'm very detailed, but I won't do that to you guys. Anyhow, this is something that is recommended to take every 6 months because a lot of people have no symptoms whatsoever. I, unfortunately, do have symptoms. In fact, I was supposed to go out today with some friends for breakfast, and that didn't happen because I had tummy issues. Mm-hmm. And so this is highly recommended, although I don't know whether this is recommended, but this is what Paulette does, is if like I've taken this and then 4 months later or 3 months later, I know my symptoms of having a parasite, I'll go out and I'll get another box. You can buy them single boxes, or you can buy them two boxes that come together. And I don't remember how much these usually run, maybe like, I don't know, maybe one box is like $8, maybe two is like $15.
Yeah, but just as a general rule, even our Mexican friends, they take them every 6 months regardless, whether they feel any symptoms or
right,
not.
Right,
so,
right.
So just as a precautionary measure.
Right, and so today I had this epiphany that where's all the that I'm getting this parasite issue way more than Mark, and I think it is because I'm the one, when we take care of the street dogs, that clean out the plastic bowls that I have for the dogs, and I use a rag and I use my hand to clean it really good because I don't want anything left in it. However, that's not very good precautions for me. Yeah. And we couldn't figure out why I kept having more issues than you. And I think that's why. Because I wasn't using any gloves, I wasn't being smart, and I would just come home, and I can't say always, because there's never an always, right? There's that 1%. Mm-hmm. Or 2%, come home and wash my hands immediately in the sink. And maybe there's that 1 or 2% chance that I haven't done it because I've gotten sidetracked or something or another, which is easy for me.
Easily, yeah. being sidetracked is easy for Paulette.
It's in my genes.
If we're working around the house, if I can't find her, I'll just follow the trail of incomplete projects that will eventually lead to her.
That's true.
I will say that I go with Paulette to, you know, take care of the street dogs, fill the food bowls, fill the water buckets and stuff like that too. And I have cleaned the buckets in the past, but my cleaning standards fell short of Paulette's expectations.
And well, so, how many times did you clean the water bowls?
Like twice. But so Paulette takes care of that.
I do. And I have high expectations, and Mark is lucky that he met those expectations.
Okay.
So I mean, figure I'm doing this twice a week, at least, and I'm using my bare hands and I'm using the rag. I mean, that is just stupid, but I never thought about that before.
Obviously, you missed the sex ed class the day that they said always wear protection. Maybe cutting class or something.
Maybe. Something like that.
So, the plan is for you to start wearing gloves.
Yeah,
like
I posted
longer
this.
Longer gloves.
I posted this on our Facebook page today, and I was talking with one of my subscribers on there, Joe. Shout out to you, Joe and Lorraine. They live in Puerto Vallarta. Joe was saying, yeah, why don't you wear some gloves? Get those thick rubber gloves, you know, that you can wash afterwards and then wash your hands up afterwards. That's a great idea. Why didn't I think about that? I don't know. I thought coming home and washing my hands in the sink with soap and water was good enough. I don't know.
What is that you always say about yourself?
I don't know.
You are not the sharpest tool in the shed, which is what it should be, but she always says, I'm not the smartest tool in the shed.
So, you know, it was probably, I don't know, one of those situations where I forgot to wash my hands because I got sidetracked is probably what happened the times that I come down with it. But I am going to get, I actually have a pair of those gloves underneath my sink. I'm going to start using those. And then Joe also suggested that I get one of those toilet scrubbers and use that with my gloves to really clean it out.
Yeah.
Well, so I'm going to do that also.
She was talking about using my toothbrush to do it, but I successfully talked her out of that.
Well, that's only when I'm pissed off at you.
Okay. Maybe I should start checking that toothbrush more often.
No, I would never do that. Although I've seen that in movies and it's been pretty funny. So I'm gonna do those two things. And I think that will make a difference for me for sure. I think I lost my card. Yeah, it flew down here. Hold on a second.
Hold on a minute, folks.
I know what I need to say, but.
We need a timeout here.
But just in case. And how I wrote these down, these are the most common symptoms. These are my symptoms, first of all. Digestive issues, tummy issues for sure is a good indication. Either diarrhea or constipation. Fatigue, that's another one that I get. And headache, but not all the time, sometimes. And then they say nausea or vomiting can also happen from the parasites in your gut. For me, I get a weird thing that happens to me. I get like I get like this buildup of saliva in my mouth, and then I feel like, you know, you get that automatic like throwing up feeling in your gut where you just automatically want to hurl. Well, anyhow, that happens to me, but I don't really throw up much at all. It's like just the saliva. My mouth just, I don't know why. I'm just a freak of nature, as Mark always says.
Freak of nature.
And I take that with a compliment.
Yeah.
Because who wants to be like everybody else? Yeah. Anyhow, so those are my symptoms. You can get rashes. There's a whole slew of symptoms that people can get. You can also, if you think that you have a parasite, you can go into a laboratory and get a stool test done, and they'll tell you for sure. Me living in Mexico for almost 4 years, I pretty much have a pretty good indication when it's hitting me. And
because you've experienced it so many times.
Well, and I'm the kind of person, you guys are finding out way too much information about me today. But
next up, colonoscopy exam.
But I'm one of those people that I look at my poop. I just do. I think it's a good thing to do. And so I always...
And then she calls me in there to look at her poop. Now, this it's a love thing because I don't willingly go, but somehow out of obedience to my wife,
how many times have I asked you to do that? I think like twice.
Yeah. Twice too many, by the way.
But you'll see that it looks different. It's just a different consistency, light and color. Mm-hmm. Just different. Mm-hmm. And sometimes I have sworn that I've seen worms in there.
And she swears a lot.
I don't swear a lot.
Oh, really? Okay.
So, but I will say that I think that I have seen parasites because I'll get like a flashlight.
Yeah.
To look in the toilet.
I know. It takes her... She spends a good long time in the bathroom after that, going through her whole routine of stuff. And then the fear, the dread sets in as I know I'm going to get the call as part of her routine.
Mark, do you think that this is parasites? Yeah. Come here and look. He's like, oh, God, no. Don't.
Sometimes I just try to answer from the living room, but she said, get in here.
Come here. Come here. I need you to look. But really... In 4 years that we've lived here and as many times as I've had this happen to me, you've only been called maybe three times.
Three times that I went sort of willingly but not willingly, knowing what the outcome is going to be.
Well, I give a lot of detail, but I won't give you a whole lot.
Yeah.
But so the parasitic med is to take every 6 months as a precaution because a lot of people will have parasites and never experience anything. I know by my symptoms when I get them, automatically, pop a pill.
So there are some natural things that you can do, preventative things.
That's right, if you don't want to do this, and there's another brand, I'm gonna have Mark look it up, I can't think of it right off. Yeah. But Loxal is one of them.
Yeah. I think the other brand is called Poop Stopper or something.
Anyhow, garlic cloves, they say. Like if you want to take a couple of garlic cloves as a precaution to prevent them.
Also good for keeping vampires away, apparently.
Well, everybody away, I think, sometimes. Yeah. And wash it down with some water. I don't know if you're supposed to chew them. They didn't say that. I couldn't chew them. I'd have a heck of a time. Apple cider vinegar, like a tablespoon and a glass of water. That's another really good way to prevent them. And black walnut hulls. You can get it in an oil. You can get it in a capsule. That's another one. Clove is another one. Because these are very strong. Okay, you want to... say the last two.
Pumpkin seeds. No, did you already cover that one?
No.
Sorry.
I didn't.
Pumpkin seeds is one. We personally have not tried that.
But I do like pumpkin seeds.
Right. Sweet potatoes, which we do like, believe it or not. I was surprised to find out that they can be a deterrent for parasites or kill them off. My personal favorite, papaya seeds. They taste a lot like pepper, and it literally is a bitter thing to swallow, but I eat like 40 or 50 at once just to get it over with. Paulette will drag it out for a long time. She'll just eat one at a time, and her face shrivels up, and then the next one, so it takes her...
Probably a half an hour.
Yeah, it takes her a long time to get through them all, whereas I just pretty much in the agony all at once.
Yeah, but you're not sensitive. You're not sensitive to spicy stuff like that. I am.
I'm a sensitive guy.
Well, not to spicy stuff.
That's true.
So, what's the other one?
Oregano oil, or as Paulette says, oregano, but it's oregano oil. And that's another one we have not tried.
No, we haven't. So, in fact, we kind of stopped doing the papaya seeds.
Yeah.
We used to do that the first year that we lived in Moralia. We did that about every 3 months, something like that.
Yeah.
So that's what we wanted to talk about, you know, how I don't think parasites can be prevented, really.
Yeah, it's only a matter of time. All you can do is be prepared for it and know what to do in case it happens. You know, when it happens, if you're traveling in Mexico, it's probably just a good idea to pick up, you know, one of these types of tablets, even if you don't have it as you're traveling, in case you do come down with it. You know, it's just a good preventative measure to have, I think.
I agree.
So,
what else was I going to talk about? Something about the parasites. I don't know, maybe you can cut all this part out.
Yeah, definitely, because people, the ones that haven't tuned out, will fall asleep.
So, okay.
Go.
That's the topic that we wanted to bring you today, because it's a real issue in Mexico, and it's a real issue in third world countries.
Yeah. Sorry about the crappy video.
Anyhow,
figuratively, hopefully not literally.
If you guys do like what we're doing, maybe with the exception of this video,
yeah,
think about subscribing to our channel, because we try to bring you information regarding Mexico all the time. And you know, we do have a Facebook page called the Two Travelers in Mexico also, where I post different articles about Mexico and different conversations.
As well as other people that have joined our page, they post articles and ask questions, things like that.
Yeah, and some YouTubers will post on there too. So, and then we post our videos usually on there after
a couple of days.
After a couple of days, we'll put them on the Facebook page too. But yeah, if you guys like what we're doing, leave us a comment down below. Share anything regarding this crappy subject with you.
And maybe even some of the preventative maintenance, preventative measures
that you guys
have done.
Yeah. Because there are a lot of people, and we fought for taking this for the longest time.
Yeah.
I would say at least 2 years in Mexico.
Yeah.
Something like that. But you know, if you're not, you know, keen on taking something every 6 months, or for me in my case, more often than that, I take it at least 3 or 4 times a year because of getting it more often. You know, then do the home remedies. There's a lot of different ones that you can find online, and that might work great for you.
Yeah.
So, again, if you guys like what we're doing, think about subscribing to our channel. Leave a comment below, join our Facebook page, and as always, from the Two Travelers in Mexico, say bye. Say bye, Brenda. Say bye-bye. Say, well, that was her wave.
Uh-huh.
And this is Fiona. Say bye. Say bye, Fiona. You hear barking dog? Right. Go get him. Anyhow, from the Two Travelers in Mexico, as always.
What she did.
Bye, guys.
Bye. For those of you who are wondering what that other sound in the video was, that was our flag whipping around.